Hi creators, welcome or welcome back to Academic Phoenix Plus. My name is Monica and I am your guide through ZBrush. In this video tutorial, we are gonna go over texturing using ZBrush, and tools we're gonna go over include alphas, poly painting, and so much more. If you're new to this channel, I post tutorials on a weekly basis. Software includes Maya, ZBrush, Substance Painter, and so much more. So if that is your sort of thing, please consider subscribing. So bring out that creativity, open up that software, and let's go ahead and get started in texturing an axe using ZBrush. I want to start with the blade. I'm going to do a control click to make sure I have this object selected, and what I want to do is figure out what type of material this is going to be. When I'm going to start working with poly paint in ZBrush, I want to know what type of material I want to use. So up here at the top, I'm going to click on mRGB, and I'm also going to turn off add because I don't want to accidentally start sculpting. To create metal, there's a variety of options here, and the one I like to use is called Z metal, but you know, you guys are welcome to try different types, such as we have Z metal, we have Fresnel overlay if you want to make something really shiny. We also have metallic, and we also have metal 01. There's a variety. I'm going to go with metal 01 because it's shiny, so that you guys can really see the effect of the shader. So the next part I'm going to do is fill this in. Otherwise, if I keep changing the material, it would change it, right? So what I'm going to do is grab metal 01, and if I need to make any changes to the material, I can actually go to material, go to modifier, and here I can change things like ambient. I can change the specularity if I want it to be sharper. Reflectivity can be more, things like that. And once I'm happy with that, I'm going to go to color, fill object. Now this only fills this object. The other ones, if I try to change it to, let's say this one, you'll notice that it changes the other ones because this one's already been filled. All right, now that I have that, the next thing I want to do is give it a little bit of noise so that I have more to paint with, because I'm going to be using a lot of masking. So what I could do is go to surface, go to noise. You can see that we'll add some really cool noise, but I don't want it to add it here. So I'm going to cancel this and I'm actually going to mask it. So let's go ahead and mask this section here. And it looks like I have symmetry on. Let me confirm. Active symmetry, great. And hold down control so I can mask this portion out. I'm gonna reduce my paintbrush to a control alt, remove the mask on the opposite end. Something like that's a little rough, but that's okay. All right, so the mask is protecting this blade. Now I can do a noise. You'll notice that it only affects it here. If you want to make it a little bit noisier, you can play around with the strength. You can also play around with the scale. Just want a little bit. And I'm going to click OK, but before I do that, don't forget to change this Z add and then apply. So let's try that again. Noise. Edit. Maybe make it a little stronger. Okay. That's what it's going to look like. Apply. Now, I don't have too much mesh, so the noise doesn't affect it too much, but that's okay. Remove the Z add, and that should give us some nice information. So what am I gonna do with this? I'm gonna go to masking, and over here we have a variety of ways to select it, but the most popular is mask by cavity. You can see that it selects the indentations, and of course, if I change the mask, control click, I get the other one. Now I can mess this around. I can play with this graph and then click on mask again, and you can see that it gets a little bit more precise and more precise and more precise depending on what I'm choosing until I can get really, really into the details. You can always click on reset and you can get it back. So you can see that the noise that I added here is being selected versus here doesn't have that much. And the point of this is to help me start painting. Before I get started on painting everything, I'm going to go ahead and remove the mask. And let's start with the basis. I'm going to start off with painting in a gradient fashion. I'm going to kind of do darker colors over here. So I'm going to grab a nice big brush. I just kind of paint it in. If you want to go a little darker around the corners, maybe over here. Just a little bit around here to give it some shading. Then start doing a little bit more this way. And then we're going to get a little lighter. And then we get lighter still, but at least there's a hint of color. I finally want to get to this corner here. I want to go all white. And I'm going to paint this blade in because I want this blade to be not pure white, but I definitely want it to be a really nice light
gray.
Now for the inside here, I do want it to be pretty dark, so I'm going to go ahead and darken it. Might want to get a less soft brush and get into the details. So let's go ahead and darken this up. Maybe give it a little hint of not red, but just a little hint of color. Right now I'm just starting off with a solid color and then I'm going to go from there. When I need to get to the details, I'm going to make a small brush, just like in Photoshop. Going to start broad and then go in from there. Now to give this a little bit more diverse color, because right now it's very flat, color diversity is going to be really important. So what I'm going to do is go over here to strokes and choose regular spray. And then that way you can, let me go a little darker here, kind of break up the color just a little bit. Same thing for this. I'm going to go choose a nice dark color and just a light spray. Just kind of break up the colors just a little bit, because the last thing we want is to have perfectly even textures. All right, so that's going to start the base. All right, now we're going to use the masking. So I'm going to click on reset. So we all start with the same thing. Click on mask by cavity. And this is going to give us the outside. If you want to get those inner dots, you do a control click and that's going to give you this one. So this is a fun one. We can just kind of go in, grab a dark color, and now we can just kind of go in and spray. Now if you want to see what's going on, do a control H so you can see the effect. So again, I'm just trying to go in and just kind of giving it a little bit of almost like dirt. I'm going to go in with a finer brush and just kind of go through here. Make sure that I get those grooves, because I want to make sure that I get some nice dark edging. Same thing here. I'm actually going to go back to dots and I'm going to turn off X for symmetry. I'm going to darken the inside here. I'll make sure it's darken those grooves so it looks like something hit it. And then I'm going to choose something lighter and go on the outer edges. So I'm going to flip it around and make sure I get those edges. I'm going to go really light here. Again, control H if you want to see the effect. And I also want to make sure that this edge right here, I'm going to turn on symmetry. I want to make sure this edge is highlighted. Well, I do have a tablet. I'll leave an affiliated link to a tablet that I use. It's a little one. I use it for a mouse as well. So if you guys want to purchase it and follow along, that would be great. You don't have to use that link. It's just easier if you have a tablet, especially when you're working with ZBrush. Now I'm going to just start highlighting some other nooks and grooves that I see here that I want to make sure I get. Make sure I get those edges because it's kind of nice to highlight them. All right, so let's say I want to make this gold. So I'm going to go back into dots, and to make gold, you have to, it's actually almost like a sickly yellow. It sounds strange, but gold is a funny looking color. So it depends how bright you want it. I'm looking at this as reference, and I can go in and just kind of eyeball it until I'm happy with the color, something like that. You can grab the cavity mask and then you can manipulate it so that, oh, let me reset that and manipulate it so that you can get that edging and then zoom in and you can go ahead and paint in the details. Oh, thank goodness for the cavity mask, because then this is a lot easier versus if there was something else, like if you were just painting this on your own. You can do a control H and you can see what's going on. Now if you're wondering why it's so pixelated, part of it's because of the low resolution mesh, but I'm not planning to zoom in too much to this. The render's going to be from afar. Okay, almost done. Now, unfortunately, this isn't like Photoshop where we have layers and we can manipulate it and all this stuff. This is more very, very painterly where you literally are painting it. All right, let's work on this one. So control click. This one has several materials. So I'm going to be using polygroups. I'm also going to hide things because it's going to be a bit challenging to work on so many items that get on the way. So I'm going to go ahead and hide everything. And obviously this is not a good material for wood. So I'm going to choose something that's a little bit basic. And there is things like basic material. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Do a color, fill object. And actually, let me choose white before I fill objects. So go ahead and select white. Color, fill object, so I have kind of like a nice base. Now to mask, I'm going to have to hold down control. I am going to grab the mask lasso. I'm just going to do a quick selection. Hopefully it selected the back. Do another one. And then grab the mask pen. Check to make sure symmetry is active, which is not. There we go. Grab a bigger brush and then mask. Might want to subtract anything by holding down Alt. That looks okay. And then we're going to do a Control W. So now we have a polygroup. I'm going to make another polygroup with this. Control W. And now I have three polygroups. Let's work on the wood. So I'm going to do a Control W click, and that gives me the wood. And I'm going to turn this off so I can see what I'm doing. And of course, I'm going to choose something a little bit more brown. So let's go ahead and start off with the base color, a little bit more orange here. And then we're going to go to color, fill object. Now this one already has a lot of groove, so we don't need to add noise to it. But let's go ahead and start creating our color. So I like to use color spray first and using a large brush and just diversifying the color right off the bat. This is just kind of like a nice base. Don't forget the bottom. And then from here, I can go to masking. I am doing this fast, but you can see how quickly I can do this. Mask by cavity. Let's go for maybe a slightly lighter color. So we can just go in. Again, do a Control H to see what's happening. Flip the mask so I can get to the grooves and make it dark. Control H so you can see what's going on and just kind of paint the grooves in. Don't forget the bottom. Now I'm going to choose a lighter color and just kind of go in just a couple of random places just to break it up a little bit. Some areas should have some lighter colors while others don't. So I'm just going to diversify it a little bit. Control shift click to see your polygroups. And now we're going to focus on the band. So control shift click for this one. I'm going to choose a pretty deep red, fill object. And for this one, we can also use, again, I like to reset and pick by cavity, and you can see that it chooses that color for me. So now I can go in and just kind of lighten it up. But I'm going to flip the mask, and this one's going to be a little darker. Control H if you want to see the effect. There you go. And then this is where we can have a little bit of fun with painting. We can instead just draw ourselves. So for example, I could go in, get a small brush, just kind of create some lines to make it feel like it's a band. Very simple. Kind of help with the blending. And then we can choose a lighter color. Just going to create some highlights. And then just going to have some fun with it. Kind of take a look from above to see what you think. All right, cool. Let's clear that. And we now have this. So then we're going to do the same thing, but with the metal. Control shift click. Actually, let me bring back my sub tool with the axe so I can see what colors I choose. And if I hold down C, I can get the color that I was choosing. And then I can go to color, fill object. It's probably too much. I'm going to do C, color, fill object, and then go from there. So again, I can grab my spray and then I can kind of spray around. Give it a little bit of noise. Speaking of that, let's turn on Z add. Let's go over here to surface noise. Take a look at it. Maybe increase the strength a little bit. Crease up, that's too much. Anything like that, click OK. Apply to mesh. And then we can go ahead and start masking. So let's go and grab the cavity mask. Don't forget to remove the add, otherwise it causes issues. And I'm gonna go a little darker, Control H to see what's going on so I can break it up a little bit. And fairly quickly I can get some really nice looking material. Flip the mask. Because I want to go a little lighter, make it smaller. I want to go a little lighter here. And then of course a little lighter here to highlight those scratches. And then play around with this. Flip it over and then we can add some really interesting colors around this area too. Grab a bigger brush. Control H, and I really wanted to highlight a little bit of these edges. All right, let's take a look at the rest of it, and let's bring this back, and you can see that we're starting to get some really cool effects. All right, I think that's a good place to stop. In the next video tutorial, we're going to cover how to texture the skull and the rest of the pieces. Let me know what you think by leaving a comment below. Did you learn a thing or two? Is there a tool that surprised you? If you like this video and you want to see more, please like and subscribe. That is your message to me, letting me know that you like this content and that you want to see more. Please share my videos if you know of an artist that would like to learn how to texture in ZBrush. Please share my video. That would be amazing. Also, take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. There you will find free resources such as 3D models, ebooks, and so much more. So take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. Again, thank you so much for watching. Really appreciate it. Keep creating, and I will see you next time in the next video tutorial where we finish texturing this battle-ready axe.